so weary. When troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Thank you. lontana, sogno all'orizzonte, manca le parole. Io sì lo so che sei con me, tu mia luna, tu sei qui con me. Mio sole, tu sei qui con me.
Stand.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, O Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? From you alone, O Lord, who by our sins are justly angered. Holy God, Holy and Mighty, Holy and Immortal One, have mercy upon us. Lord, you know the secrets of our hearts. Shut not your ears to our praise, but spare us, O Lord. Holy God, Holy and Mighty, Holy Immortal One, have mercy upon us. Please be seated for the eulogy by Zelma Daisley.
Thank you.
morning church. It gives me great pleasure that I can share a few words of remembrance today as we are all gathered to celebrate and give thanks to this phenomenal lady we call Majoyce Grand Anana. Joyce Muriel Arthur was born on January 28, 1933, and on September 27, 2021, she went to be with her father in heaven. She was the mother of two daughters, Romel Arthur, deceased, and Eurita Arthur. She was a sister of Janice Arthur, grandmother of Ryan, Dave, Steve, Nicole, and Primar Arthur, great-grandmother of Zarian Arthur and Azaria Aki, a mother figure to many. As a young woman, Joyce worked very hard to take care of her family. She also enjoyed life to the fullest, as she knew best at the time, and she was one whose actions spoke many words. She was a fighter, not only in struggling to survive, but in taking care of her children and family. If you messed with any of them, you messed with Joyce, who will physically fight you without any fear. Joyce had many sayings. Some of her favorites were, "It's not what you do, but how you do it," "No one can say what you did not say," and "Let them think you are foolish, head and brain." Joyce had an excellent and loving bond with her two great-grands. Zarian called her Grand, and Azaria called her Nana. They all enjoyed plenty of dance movements with her, which brought much joy and amazement to us. She was active despite her age, and still moved so easily and briskly on her feet. She loved to dance, and until the day she passed, she was very light on her feet. She was a member of Covenant Life Teaching Center, and we were told that Pastor there highlighted her to the congregation one Sunday as she was spotted dancing during worship. As Joyce got older, she turned from the things of the world and started going to church at Abundant Life Assembly and then to Faith Temple Ministries International, where she accepted Jesus as Savior and Lord and was later baptized. Joyce's conversion was quick and steadfast. She never missed a moment to testify to God's goodness in speaking to others or letting them know He was in control. Each day on rising, Joyce would not leave her room unless she had an early appointment, and she would usually be in bed reading her Bible and talking to the Lord. Psalms 23 and Psalms 121 were her favorite scriptures. She stood firm in what she believed, and she was not easily persuaded from it. Joyce's lifestyle is a legacy that lives on with us today. She would often say it is better to give than to receive. Even in difficult times when she needed, she would always give to others. You just have to turn up, say the word, and Joyce would find something to give you. Rest assured, when you left the house, you were carrying something in your hand or stomach if you did not refuse. Her daughter Rita once said, "I am going to start swimming with one eye open because I know I might wake up and find myself at another house," implying that Joyce would give her away, not understanding the principle of giving at that time. "Give and it will come back to you" was another one of her favorite sayings. Joyce certainly received the more and just when she needed it. Joyce was a reserved person who kept to herself and would listen more than talk, especially if she did not know you. Once you were known and appreciated by her, you were in for moments of old-time sayings, lots of jokes, and much laughter from what she said and from her facial expressions. Joyce had a sharp wit and was known for giving you a dose of sarcasm and teasing. Joyce, the fashionista. She loved to dress up, have fun, and yes, bring on the compliments of how good she looked. She was a real hot stepper, chic, trendy, and stylish. Joyce was a specialist in cooking cuckoo with anything on the side.
She cooked cuckoo about 3 weeks before she passed. Many love Joyce's cuckoo. It is amazing that a woman of her age had so many young friends who would often call and spend hours on the phone with her. We often heard the occasional laughter or comment from her side, or just a distant murmuring sound as she shared with them. No conversation ended without mentioning how good God is. Joyce lived a full life, and her service to God was seen in how she embraced others, showed love, compassion, and a realistic view towards life. Ma Joycey, we love you, and we will cherish the moments, life lessons, cooking skills, and fashion trends during the years that God blessed us with you in our lives. We take comfort in that your absence from us, you are present with God. And we know that every praise is to our God. Amen.
Let me hear the worshipers! Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together, because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
We'll have a tribute by Pastor Wesley Dare, to be followed by a second tribute by Pastor Seth Glasgow.
Blessed good morning to everybody. I am sure this morning that you will agree that every praise is to our God. And I'm honored this morning to be given the opportunity to say a few words on behalf of our sister Joyce. And I first obviously want to give honor to minister in charge here, Reverend Rogers, and for allowing me to come be a part of this great celebration for the life of a great woman. Joyce Arthur, affectionately called Sister Joycey, was a faithful member of the Covenant Life Teaching Center for about 19 years. And from the time she joined the ministry, she became a favorite, not only with those in her age group, but also with the younger members of the assembly, who were always fascinated at how fashionable Sister Joycey dressed and how well she looked for her age. Joycey was not one of many words at all. In fact, she was considered to be rather reserved. But if you wanted to get her talking, you just had to ask her about her grandchildren, and she would talk about them for the next hour or so if you didn't stop her. It was very evident that she loved her family and enjoyed giving updates of the various journeys and development and the happenings in the life of her grands. It was clear that family meant everything to her. Sister Joyce, she loved to worship, she loved to dance, she loved to be in the house of the Lord, and she was known to support everything that was hosted by the church. In fact, I cannot recall ever missing her from any of the events, especially for the seniors. She was a definite show. At Covenant Life, she was respected as a model senior, not only because of the way she carried herself, but more importantly, she was one who didn't have a problem giving you a quiet word of encouragement or rebuke if necessary, in a loving manner, in a loving way. And her smile was one of the things that you will never forget about Sister Joycey. Her laughter, though not loud, was a trademark of hers as well. We were, like all of the family, looking forward to celebrating many more birthdays with her, many more years with her, but God wanted her more than we did. So on behalf of the leadership, the members of the Covenant Life Church, we offer our sincere condolences to the entire family, sympathy to the family, and we will continue to pray with you and for you as you reflect on the life of a great woman. Although it is always hard to say goodbye, and even harder in these trying times, difficult times, we are comforted knowing that our beloved Sister Joycey is resting safely and peacefully in the arms of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May she rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen.
Temple Ministries International. I'm sure I'm speaking for Pastor Lemuel and Pauline. Speaking for them, they had the joy of knowing her and introducing her to the Lord. Joycey. So to the Arthur and the Tull family, we pray for you. We stand with you. And we speak the strength of God, and we extend our deepest sympathy and condolences to you. And may the Lord, joy of the Lord be your strength. Joycey, small in nature, in stature, but a gigantic woman of strength and love and kindness. I see her as an angel. Every time I see her, she looks like an angel. And I love to see her with her white, low haircut. She was the cutest with that hairstyle. And there are times when I would talk to her, she would say that she's waiting on Ryan to come and give her that haircut. I mean, you look at the hair, there's not much to cut, but she's waiting for that haircut. She's always waiting on Ryan. And I've heard about the way that she dressed. She always looks beautiful, dressed nice, and also smells nice. That's one of the things that my wife loves about her. And also, the thing that I love about her most is her cuckoo. She she made me fall in love with Cuckoo. As you know, I am a citizen of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, so for the first time when I came to Barbados and tasted this thing called Cuckoo, for the first time, couldn't get it eat. But when Joyce did it, and I tasted it, hers was much different and much better than all the other cuckoo that I tasted. And so from that day on, I used to pass by the bridge every Saturday and collected my cuckoo. So Joyce won me over by her cooking. I heard about her cooking earlier today. And we all know that Eureta don't eat pork, Nicole don't eat pork, nor Llewellyn. So there are times when she would do the cooking and she would say, "Seth, I got a little piece there for me and you," because she like to eat a little pork here and there. She would always say, "I got peace for me and you." So Joyce has that small, soft voice. Joyce will be talking on the phone. Sometimes I'm talking with her on the phone, and I have to hold the phone very close in order to hear what she's saying. She was always a soft-spoken person. She will whisper softly. And so if you call the house, the first person who will answer the phone, but now you have Zari. Zari will probably answer the phone before Joyce. But Joyce will be the person who will answer the phone, and you will be greeted with a small, soft, beautiful, kind voice. And if you call for Eureta, you can be sure that you will have a conversation with Joyce before you get to speak to Llewellyn or Eureta or Nicole or whoever you call to talk to. And she always greets you with a smile. And there are times when every time I go over to the house, she will greet me with a hug. And because she's small in stature, she will hug me around my waist and she will give you a smile. And she will always ask you, "How are you doing?" And she will always give you the word. I love how she dresses. She looks like an angel. She's not only a dresser, not a cook, but she's a woman of God. A powerful woman of God, a woman of faith, an anointed woman. She might not have had a pulpit, but Joyce preached. She ministered. She was a powerhouse. Today, my wife has a piece of paper with about 10 scriptures that Joyce wrote on a piece of paper. And then we went to the house and Joyce gave her the paper. Nobody saw when she did it, but the paper has on about 10 scriptures. And she said to my wife, "I know you're working at the airport, and I know that you'll be faced with challenges, and I know that people will be against you, but these scriptures are for you. I want you to pray them." And she said, I'm praying them for you." And at the right hand corner of the paper, Joyce wrote, "Mom loves you." And my wife has that paper for a couple of years now, and she's gonna get it laminated. But that's what Joyce did. That's her ministry. That's how much she loves you. If you go wrong, Joyce, she will always love you. And nobody in the house knew that she gave my wife that paper. And she would always say to us that she's praying for us. And she is praying because she is a woman of God. And so early in this year, I went to the house and we were talking about the pandemic and all the challenges that we are faced with. And we walked on and on and on about all the things that is wrong with the world. And at the end of the conversation, Joyce said these words to me. I've heard them before, but this time the words came from her with such an anointing. She said to me, "Seth, God is still in control and he's on his throne. He's in control." And I tell you, those words coming from this short woman who is such an anointing, it shook my whole body. It gave me a confidence to know that God is still in control. And she's saying that to a preacher. And those words echoed in my spirit and they haven't left me since she said them, and we are still in this pandemic. And these words are the words that I want to leave with you today, the same words that she spoke to me. God is in control. He's on his throne. And we will see Joyce again. I want to thank God for her. She has been a blessing in my life. And we're going to see her again in her glorified body, because she was a child of the King. So we love you, Joyce. And may God continue to allow the joy of the Lord to be the strength of the family and the friends. God bless you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Thank you for the first scripture reading. read by Nicole Arthur.
Good morning. The first scripture reading is taken from Revelations 21, 2 to 7. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and he and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. That he overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. The word of God.
Thanks be to God. Remain seated for the reading of Psalm 23 by Azariah Aki.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The word of the Lord.
The Gospel reading from John chapter 14 will be read by Premier Arthur.
The scripture reading is from John 14, verses 1 to 6. Jesus said, Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The word of the Lord.
The hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine.
Let us pray. Almighty God, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Kindly sit, please. Some words from the book of the Revelation, chapter 21 and the 7th verse. They who overcome will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. They who overcome will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. When the group of church fathers met sometime towards the end of the 2nd century AD to compile what we now know as the New Testament, having already accepted the Old Testament as their corpus, having already been a part of the Old Testament community, they decided to end their corpus of the New Testament in very much the same way the Old Testament started, with a story of creation. And so Revelation 21 and 22 represent a creation story from the New Testament, but it is far removed from the creation story of the Old, because all of the things that characterize the negativity of the first creation will become things of the past in the new. For example, there is no sea. The sea represented a place of chaos in the Old Testament. In this new creation, there will be no sea. And as we sing from time to time in many of our Christian songs, the sea represents a place of turmoil. When upon life's billows we are tempest tossed, and everything to do with the sea has some negative connotation. But here in this new creation, there will be no sea. And all of the things and the encumbrances and uncertainties of life in this world will become things of the past. Death will be no more. Neither will there be pain or sorrow or crying anymore, for the former things have passed away. And this was being written by someone whose community was experiencing the brunt of persecution. John, exiled on the Isle of Patmos, was sending a message back to the Christians in the diaspora who were experiencing persecution, both at the hands of the Romans and the hands of Jews. And he was telling them to hold on to your faith. Do not give in, because it was a time when Christians were being pressured to recant. If you deny your faith in Jesus, we let you live. And John said, no, do not give in to your faith. Hold on, because there is something greater in store for you. Those who overcome will inherit all these wonderful things. But you first have to go through the hardships of life in this world. And so the new creation is not necessarily something different from the old, but it is merely a continuum. And so life in this world is very much the testing ground and the place in which we procure life in the world to come. We first have to endure the hardships of life in this world and finding God in the midst of the darkness that we experience in this life, in order to experience the bliss of the world to come. As I sat and listened to the various tributes from her pastors and from her family, I could not help but think that Joyce was one who went through this very step in life. She faced the ups and downs of life in this world. She faced them head on. There are times, we're told, when she had to fight for existence. And sometimes that happens in this world. Sometimes life pressures us to that point where we feel we have to push back. But we also heard of someone who, in the midst of all that she might have been experiencing in this life, found time to laugh, found time to dance, but most importantly, found time for others. For ultimately, that is how we'll be judged. Our judgment will come based on our relationships with our fellow human beings. Our judgment will come when we're able to look beyond ourselves to share our lives with others.
Our sister was able to do that. Not only in a tangible way by the cuckoo she cooked every Saturday, but also by just being there as a listening ear for even the younger ones in her assembly. And that is so important, because what she really lived out was the criteria of the final judgment in Matthew 25. Matthew said, when the master comes and you'll be judged, yes, how many times you went to church will be important. How well you sang will be important. How well you can quote scripture, that's good. But your judgment will really be based on how you touch the lives of other people. In Matthew 25, verse 31 and following, St. Matthew gives us what the criteria for judgment will be like. I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was in prison, and you visited me. I was sick, and you took time out to care for me. I was a stranger, and you made me feel like I was a part of everything. And we're told that many will ask, but Lord, when did we see you like this and did these things for you? And his response will be, inasmuch as you did it to the least of one of these, your brothers or sisters, you've done it to me. Our sister Joyce did exactly that. Of whatever she had, she sought to share with those around her. She sought to bring comfort to the lives of people around her. She offered counsel for those who needed it at that time. She gave of herself. In this life, she was able to live for others. And it is in living for others that we really live for God. It is in reaching out and touching the lives of other people, salving those wounds, binding up the brokenhearted, just being there as a listening ear. We not only overcome in this world for ourselves, but we show others the way how they can overcome the challenges of life in this world. For that is really the journey for the Christian in this world. It is a constant battle. And the more we have working on our side, the better off we are. Our sister Joyce worked not only for herself. She not only overcame personally in this life, but in reaching out to others, she helped them to overcome the obstacles of life in this world, which they confronted as well. And ultimately, that is what God requires of us. That is all her God required of her. And perhaps as we gather here today, giving thanks to God for placing amongst us so beautiful a soul, it gives us the opportunity to look at our own journey. It gives us the opportunity to think about our own ministry in this world. Because the ministry is not only for the pastors. The ministry is for each one of us. We come to church and we come to the assembly to fortify each other so that we can go into the world to transform it. Our sister Joyce sought to transform the world. What are we doing with the time that God has given us? How are we interacting with those around us? Are we sources of upliftment? Or are we just there to pull down? Are we sources of liberation? Or are we sources of oppression? These are all questions we must ask ourselves, and you're probably asking yourself, how can I be a source of oppression? What do I do? Go back to that final judgment in St. Matthew's Gospel. Have you ever left anyone in this world naked? Naked of their pride? Naked of their self-worth? Have you left anyone in this world thirsty? Thirsty for justice. Thirsty just to be recognized as someone. If you have done that, you are a source of oppression. Our job is to give people that thing that can quench them. And it's not about physical water or physical food. It is about being there as Joyce was there, as our sister was there. It is about reaching out to others. Just being that listening ear. Just offering that little paper with those scripture verses. Saying, Mom loves you. I'm thinking about you. I care about what you're going through. Though the world may condemn you, I am here for you. That is how we clothe people in this world. That is how we quench their thirst. That is how we welcome them when they're estranged from the world. It doesn't mean that they're not worthy of condemnation. But remember, as James told us, there is only one judge and one lawgiver. And it's not any one of us. Our job here in this world is to do simply what Joyce sought to do. To help to make the lives of others better. To help people to overcome in this world. For in so doing, we too will overcome the obstacles of life in this world. And at the last attain to that place where we believe our sister will be, where death will be no more. Neither will there be pain or sorrow or crying anymore, for the former things have passed away. To you, her family and friends, and also to the members of her church and her pastors, I encourage you to hold on to the memories of our sister and impart them to future generations, not only of your family, but of the church family as well. Here in our tradition, we have a way of erecting plaques in the church to remind us of persons who would have served in particular generations. Whatever your tradition is, make sure that the memories of this woman who sought to serve her God in the best way she knew, who exemplified joy even in the midst of the struggles of this life, who was there as a listening ear for others who needed it, who was there as a symbol of encouragement for those who needed to be encouraged, make sure that her memory is transmitted for generations to come. I take this opportunity to extend condolences to you on behalf of the parish family here at St. George. And I encourage you to grieve during this moment. But when the pain of the present time subsides, give thanks to God. Give thanks to God for the beautiful soul that was our sister Joyce. Give thanks to God for all that she would have imparted in her time. And may Almighty God grant unto her eternal rest, and let light perpetual shine upon her. And may her soul, and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace, and on that last day, rise to eternal glory. Amen. Let us now reaffirm our faith in this almighty and ever-present God, as we say together the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
After each petition, your response is, hear our prayer. We pray for those who mourn, especially the Arthur family. We commemorate the departed, Joyce Muriel. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May we be strengthened in our faith, live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Show your mercy to the dying. Strengthen them with hope and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Father of all, we pray to you for Joyce Muriel and for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. And may she and all your faithful departed through your tender mercy rest in peace. Amen.
Can it be that I should gain?
Thank you.
Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to light of the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel.
A glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom that was prepared for you." Joyce Muriel, into paradise may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you to that holy city, Jerusalem. Amen. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man, born of a woman, has but a short time to live. Like a flower he blossoms and then withers, like a shadow he flees and never stays. In the midst of life we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Joyce Muriel, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this our sister Joyce Muriel and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord. And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed for the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
And the Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious unto her. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon her and give her peace, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Thank you.
The hymn, Safe in the Arms of Jesus. Safe in the arms of Jesus. Safe on the gentle breast. There by his love, shaded. Safely my Savior shall rest. Heart is the voice of angels, born in the song to me. For the peace of glory over the sacristy. Safe in the arms of Jesus, safe on his gentle breast. There by his love, shaded, sweetly my Savior shall rest. Safe in the arms of Jesus, safe from the brooding care, safe from the world's temptation, sin cannot harm me there. Free from my doubt and faith, only a few more trials, only a few more tears. Safe in the arms of Jesus, safe on his gentle breast, there by his love, shaded. Sweetly my soul shall rest. Jesus, my heart did refuge. Jesus has died for me. Firm on the rock of ages, ever my God shall be. Here let me wait with patience, wait till the night is o'er. Wait till I see the morning break on the golden shore. Sweet in the arms of Jesus, safe on his gentle breast. There by his love, shadowed, sweetly my soul shall rest.
Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to another. Before the mountains were brought forth, or the land and the earth were born, from age to age you are God. You turn us back to the dust and say, go back, O child of earth. For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past, and like a watch in the night. You sweep us away like a dream. We fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning it is green and flourishes. In the evening it is dried up and withered. For we consume away in your displeasure. We are afraid because of your wrathful indignation. Our iniquities you have set before you, and our secret sins in the light of your countenance. When you are angry, all our days are gone. We bring our years to an end like a sigh. The span of life is 70 years, perhaps in strength even 80. Yet the sum of them is but labor and sorrow, for they pass away quickly and we are gone. Who regards the power of your wrath? Who rightly fears your indignation? So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long will you tarry? Be gracious to your servants. Satisfy us by your loving kindness in the morning. So shall we rejoice and be glad all the days of our life. Make us glad by the measure of the days that you have afflicted us, and the years in which we have suffered adversity. Show your servants your works, and your splendor to their children. May the graciousness of the Lord our God be upon us. Prosper the work of our hands. Prosper our handiworks. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, he prepared for us a place when we all get to heaven. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus,
sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place when we all get to heaven. What a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory while we walk the pilgrim pathway. Clouds will overspread the sky, but when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the price of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon his beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Love of Jesus, sing His mercy and His grace. In the mansion, bright and blessed, He'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trust in serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the course of life begin. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
Let us pray. Mighty God, we give you thanks again for the opportunity you've given to us to celebrate the life of our sister Joyce. We ask that you will bless us as we prepare to leave before our separate ways. Thank you today for your grace. We thank you for your love. And we thank you for the peace that we find in Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. To this end, we now pray that you will bless us.
Amen. Thank you.
and the thing that keeps us from drifting apart is the fact that we're bound by our soul and our heart. Every power on earth,
every storm we'll survive.
Come hell or high water, love won't be denied.
You, I
wish you were here.
It's time just like I desperately need you, and I wish you were here.
You were here, baby.
There's a world of love inside us to share.
I wish you were here.
Far too many nights, too many fights, when we should be making up. Let's get
you.